Hi, and welcome to the third and final vlog of my 2 month long visit to Cape Town last year. In this final short vlog, I'll give you a tour around the Cape Peninsula, a beautiful natural area that stretches out from Cape Town into the Atlantic Ocean. The peninsula is located south of Cape Town and measures almost 50 kilometers in length. Public transport to the peninsula is limited, so a car is the best way to explore the area. With friends from the hostel, I made a day trip around the peninsula, stopping at several points along the way. The peninsula is very mountainous. It's basically one long extension of the Table Mountain range. The roads along the peninsula are therefore quite steep and windy, with beautiful views. As we drove south from Cape Town, we followed the Chapman's Peak Drive, a very scenic route up in the cliffs, high above the sea. There are several small towns located along the coast, cute little places with nice houses and small ports full of yachts and fishing boats. We stopped in Hout Bay and Kommertje for a stroll along the beach and a visit to one of the many lighthouses. Continuing further south, we entered the Table Mountain National Park, which covers a large part of the peninsula. This protected area is quite unique, as it supports a high diversity of endemic flora. It is located in the so-called Cape Floral Kingdom, the smallest of only 6 unique floral kingdoms in the world. The plant life here is distinctly different from the rest of Africa, and it contains many endemic plants which only exist here on the Cape. The drive through the park is very nice and leads you all the way to the southern tip of the peninsula, the Cape of Good Hope. This iconic location was historically an important waypoint for European traders on their way to India and the East, as it's close to the most southern point of Africa. The Cape of Good Hope also lies in the zone where the Atlantic Ocean and the Indian Ocean meet each other. Warm water from the Algunas current mixes with the cold Benguela current, creating a unique microclimate that is rich in aquatic life. Another famous inhabitant of the Cape Peninsula is the African penguin, which lives in a colony on the east coast of the peninsula. This colony can be visited on Boulders Beach, where you can see the funny little animals walk along the beach and swim in the ocean. The penguins are about 60 centimeters tall and have a thick layer of black and white feathers, which insulates their body and keeps them warm underwater. The baby penguins are born with a thick, fluffy coat of down feathers, which is slowly replaced by their adult coat. On the land, the birds look quite clumsy and awkward, but in the water, they are super agile swimmers. Sadly, the African penguin is highly endangered. Its population has declined by 95% since pre-industrial times. Climate change, human encroachment, loss of habitat, oil pollution, and overfishing are all major threats. At Boulder Beach, the colony is being protected, and artificial shelters have been installed as safe breeding places for the penguins. Despite this, their numbers keep declining, and it is expected that the African penguin will be extinct from the wild by the end of this decade. The eastern side of the peninsula that Boulder and Simon Towns are on touch a large sea inlet called False Bay. It's a marine protected area with many aquatic animals using it as their breeding area. It is also popular for surfing and is lined by several touristic beaches and towns, such as Muizenberg. A visit to the Cape Peninsula is a definite must when in Cape Town. Its beautiful nature provides some welcome change to the bustling city of Cape Town, and it really shows off the incredible diversity of South Africa. Thanks for watching this third and final vlog on Cape Town. I hope you enjoyed them and are maybe tempted to visit this fantastic place yourself sometime. Until next time.